Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today I'm going to talk about Java collection. So this topic is very important, not only for Selenium web driver automation testing, it's very important for interview as well, because people definitely will ask you Java collection related problems and questions. So it's very important. So in the last video we have seen, we have talked about Java array. So there are some limitations in Java array. Those will be overcome by Java collection. So what are those limitations? Like size is fixed in array, and we can have similar type of data types. So these are the some limitations in Java array, and to overcome those problems, or you can say drawbacks, Java collection is introduced. So this is very important topic. So the collection in Java is a framework that provides an architecture basically to store and manipulate the data, manipulate the group of objects basically. So then, I mean, suppose we want to perform some certain actions on data, like addition, the deletion, or sorting, searching, etc. So using Java collection we can provide all those operations. So as name says that collection, right? So it's collection is a group of objects, and it's a framework which consists of different interfaces and different classes, such as list, set, queue, maps, etc. So it's very important topic. So we'll cover the basic, or you can say the introduction part of collection today. So this is the typical definition of Java collection. So a collection is a group of individual objects represented as a single unit, okay? And another definition would be Java collections can achieve all the operations that you perform on a data, such as searching, sorting, insertion, manipulation, and deletion, right? So some APIs have already been written. So using those APIs, we can say different methods have already been written using these collections. So you can use those methods to perform some actions, right? So suppose set of data is there, so we can perform these operations. In Selenium automation also we need a lot this collection, because in Selenium what we do, we generally we work with objects, right? So we have to perform some operations on different objects. So we use collection framework a lot in Selenium WebDriver testing as well. So the Java collection framework is collection of interfaces and classes which helps in sorting and processing the data efficiently. Okay, so these are the definition of collection. Okay, so now we are going to discuss in coming session about different interfaces like list, set, queue, dq, sorted set, etc., and different classes like array list, linked list, vector, stack, priority queue, hash set, linked hash set, tree set, map, hash map, linked hash map, tree map, and hash table. So there are different I mean each interfaces or classes have their own different objects. I mean they have their own properties. Like in list, list allowed the duplicate values, and it list maintains the insertion order. And if you talk about the set, that in set we cannot have duplicate values, right? And in queue, the name says that in queue, I mean it works on the basis of first in first out FIFO data structure. So I'll draw a diagram today which tells you about the relationship between different interfaces and classes. So we'll talk about the architecture today, and from next class onwards we can talk about individual interfaces and classes later on. Okay, so let's draw the diagram first. So the first interface is iterable. Let me write that. So iterable is the supermost interface, and there is a collection interface. Collection interface. So collection interface extends iterable interface. Okay. Now there are three interfaces. Like this. List, set, and queue. List interface, queue interface, and the last one is set. So there are three interfaces: list, queue, and set. And so here I denote interfaces with square or rectangle. Okay, and I'll denote classes with this oval shape. So there would be four classes here actually, and four. Okay. This is for a list, linked list, okay, and this is vector, and all three three implements, because class can implement interface, right? Extends comes when two interfaces will be there, like this collection will be extends this another interface, right? So similarly here, this is class, so it will implement list interface. So all these three classes, array list, linked list, and vector, implements list interface. And the last one is this one, is stack class. Which extends vector class. Okay, so between class and class, one class can extend another class. So here extends keyword comes. Here also extend keywords come, and all three classes will implement an interface, that is list. Okay, now let's talk about queue. So there is a class here, this is called priority queue. priority queue, and we have an interface here. Which is DQ. And we have another class that is ReadyQ. So this class implements queue interface, and this interface implements queue interface. Sorry, this DQ extends queue interface. And this ReadyDQ class implements DQ interface, and linked list also implements DQ interface. So this is the relationship between linked list and DQ. Now let's talk about set. So there are two classes here. And one interface will come here, and we have one class. Hash set class and linked hash set. Linked hash set class, and this should be sorted set interface. And at last we have tree set. So hash set and linked hash set will implement set interface. Okay, whereas sorted set extends set interface. Okay, and preset implements sorted set interface. Yeah, so this is the collection framework. Collection framework. So another, if you go here, we have map as well, linked hash map, tree map. So map, map I have not mentioned here. So we have another interface map. So which is separate one. So we'll create the hierarchy for map as well. So map is similar to this set interface. Except one more class will come here. So let's draw that. So this is map interface. Map interface, and we have three classes like this. these are hash map linked hash map, and last one is hash table. So all three classes will implement map interface. Okay, and similarly we have a sorted map and tree map. So here I'll draw this. Sorry, this is interface. Sorted map which extends map interface, and we have class tree map. Tree map which will implement sorted map interface. Okay, so yeah, so this collection framework, so iterable is the most the supermost interface and which is extended by collection framework. And collection framework there are three sub interfaces like list, queue, set. So these three interfaces extends collection framework, or sorry, collection interface. So similarly in the in list we have three classes, array list, linked list, vector and stack, four classes. So these three classes, array list, linked list, vector, will implements list interface, and another class is there is stack which extends vector class. Okay, so guys, from the next video onwards we'll talk about the interfaces which are important and different classes like array list, linked list. So I have listed down all these interfaces and classes, so from next class onwards we'll talk about them in detail, like how it works and what are the different methods and what are the different properties. As I have discussed, like list can take duplicate values, where set we can't, set can not allow the duplicate values, similar kind of things. So we'll talk about all these things stuff in coming sessions. Okay, so thank you for watching, have a nice day, bye bye.